The more extreme the landscape and climate, the greater their effects on the inhabitants. Temperate climes are, happily, less effective cradles of what David Hume called sick men's dreams. On the other hand, they do promote the greatest of human virtues, skepticism, cynicism in its true sense, and doubt. The Isle of Rust is entirely atypical of the UK as it is today. There are 50 churches, one for every 400 people in a population of 22,000. Over a third of those people attend a church every Sunday, a vastly larger proportion than anywhere else in Britain. Though it must be noted, too, that two-thirds of the population is non-observant. This church at Rodal is the most impressive medieval building on Rust, but it would be nothing special elsewhere in North Britain. It's the exception that proves the rule of the island's church's unfailing banality and unfailing dreariness. The idea that a church might be visually enjoyable is alien to Calvinism. Enjoyment?
Whilst Presbyterian sects are forever diverging over doctrinal nuances which are invisible to the lay observer, they're united in their contempt for the pursuit of beauty. The Jezebel architecture is a papist strumpet. Icons are sacrilegious. Music is the devil's work. Ritual is theatre, which is an abomination. The idea of delighting the eye is an offence against modesty.
These insipid buildings incite us to lead a life in fear of life. They're the very obverse of the great stone circles, which are hymns to mankind.
I want a Sunday kind of love.
Unlike, say, Anglicanism, Calvinism demands commitment. It's a matter of conviction and unconditional acquiescence. It affects the way its adherents lead their constrained life. Even though it is today a minority pathology, it still attempts to create a cultural tyranny and to impose its morals and wacky brand of tolerance on the majority, who can think for itself. The most evident manifestation of the sacred's contamination of the secular is on Sundays, the Lord's Day, the Sabbath. Even though, despite the clamorous objections of the minority, a Sunday ferry now sails, the island closes down. Work of any sort is disapproved of, but so is leisure. Don't tend your garden. Don't go for a walk. Don't listen to music. Don't go fishing. Don't swim. Don't. Prescribe this, prohibit that. The cause may be delusional credulousness, but it results in the greatest of modern luxuries. Silence. Calm. Something close to serenity. It causes us to realise that there is a secular case for Sabbatarianism. For, anyway, a day that is different, not necessarily Sunday. A day when there is nowhere to lout about at lunchtime, to chant in the afternoon, to get into a stramash, to buy pointless things in an atmosphere where your ears hurt because of drivelling pop noise and your nose hurts because of burger stench. It is, of course, conceivable that the Sabbath is uncomplainingly observed because so much of the population is in no condition to do anything but slump after the previous evening's Nordic exertions. Our race's most widespread means of escapism are religious faith and insensate intoxication. For a totally satisfactory result, combine the two in the manner of dervishes, berserkers, and shamans. Oh, they certainly know how to escape themselves. Until the beginning of this decade, all alcohol was imported. In 2001, Andrew Ribbons established the Hebridean Brewery. And last year, Marco Tabern set up the Aveen Jarrett Distillery, the Red River Distillery. Apt, if belated, for whiskey, Ushkave is the only Gaelic word most of the world knows. Gaelic, in this instance, has nothing to do with France. This island has Scotland's largest concentration of Gaelic speakers. If, that is, one discounts Glasgow's Gaelic-speaking ghetto of Gaelic language media dimensioning operatives, Gaelic language propagation strategists, Gaelic language participation leaders, Gaelic language education vanguard managers. The self-important sociolinguistic industry is, of course, risible, but the language it supports most certainly isn't. That only 60,000 people speak it is no reason to allow it to wither on the tongue. The fact that it might be more practical to allow the English language to vanquish it is of no moment. Practicality is an infirm criterion. Think of Gaelic as a threatened system of cultural ecology, or compare it to a species nearing extinction, or a spirituous liquor which might disappear because the recipe was lost, as in a way it was. Much that is peculiar to rust.
Gugger, for instance, gannet. Every August, 10 men make a hazardous 40-mile journey to the uninhabited island of Sula Skare. They spend a fortnight there, trapping and then salting gannet chicks. This was once alimentary necessity. The meat apparently tastes like chicken fed on fish meal. I'm going to give it a miss, just as I gave fermented trout a miss.